Where does the history of nursing begin in Canada?
In 1617, Marie-Rolet Hebert arrived in New France, which is now called Quebec. Mary was the first immigrant to New France. She came to assist her husband, Louis Hebert, who was a surgeon and cared for Aboriginals and new settlers who were ill. Believe it or not, in 1629, men were the first nurses to attend to the sick in a healthcare center in Nova Scotia. Yes, this is true. Moving forward a decade, 1639 to be exact, the first nursing mission was established just outside of Quebec by three Augustine nuns. It was also the year that the first trained nurses immigrated to Quebec from France. Nurses were considered administrators and not your typical modern-day nurse. Jeanne Mance was a pretty special lady. She arrived in New France in 1642, where she opened the first hospital called Hôtel Dieu in Ville-Marie, Montreal. It was a whopping 30-bed hospital! Wow!
Let's fast forward to 1738. The Sisters of Charity of Montreal were a unique Canadian order of nuns. These ladies were known as Les Sœurs Gris, or the Grey Nuns. This term was actually a derogatory term at this time because it meant the tipsy nuns. The Grey Nuns were considered the first visiting nurses in Canada, and over time were respected for their work as public health nurses. During this time, they were given a charter to take over the General Hospital of Montreal. Interestingly enough, the Grey Nuns made military garments, tents, started a brewery and a tobacco plant, and operated a freight and cartage business to help with expenses for the hospital.
In the 18th and 19th century, the most common health problems were smallpox, influenza, measles, scarlet fever, typhoid, typhus, and tuberculosis.
From 1844 to 1859, Grey Nuns traveled way across Canada with a mission to care for the sick. They visited patients in their homes while they provided care for Aboriginal settlements. There is no beating around the bush about the high demand of nurses required in these small settlements. The demand was so great, they built a separate hospital building.
Who is the founder of modern nursing? That's right, the one and only Florence Nightingale! Florence Nightingale was well educated, became an advocate for the health of people, and was known as the first health statistician. How cool is that? Her worldwide fame came from her success in reducing morbidity and mortality through exemplary nursing care, such as applying the principles of cleanliness and comfort to nursing care.
Do you know what really shaped the birth of Canadian nursing? Surely you should have guessed that was the medical advances. 1830 was a big year. This is when microscopes were invented, which helped discover that diseases came from bacteria. Yes, this was a big year, but 1846 was also crucial. This was the year that ether was introduced, the first anesthetic, which was then replaced by chloroform. We know how important anesthetics are, especially during surgery. Without them, we would be in a lot of pain. Thank you, William T.G. Wharton.
Here we go. Let's start with the basics. The first Canadian Diploma Nursing School was established in 1874 at St. Catherine's General and Marine Hospital. The standards for acceptance were plain English education, good character, and Christian motives. Some of the mandatory classes were chemistry, sanitary science, physiology, anatomy, and hygiene. The student nurses were taught to observe patients for changes in temperature, skin conditions, pulse, respiration, and functions of organs. Yep, you could say not much has changed.
The School of Nurses at the Toronto General Hospital was established in 1881.
1882, Ottawa Board of Health was established.
Mary Agnes Snively was the mother of nursing. She believed that the three most important characteristics of a nurse were self-sacrifice, loyalty of duty, and heroism. She improved the nursing program by introducing a three-year course that included 84 hours of practical nursing and 119 hours of instruction by the medical staff. As well, she helped form the Canadian National Association of Trained Nurses, no big deal. In 1886, smallpox vaccine was introduced.
And in 1887, Winnipeg General Hospital was the first training school for nurses in Western Canada. 1891, Vancouver General Hospital School of Nursing opened.
Unfortunately, during this time, hospitals were seen as a place of healing for the poor, as those who were rich could afford home health care. In 1893, the popularity of hospitals had grown, and all economic classes benefited from care in the hospital.
Victoria Order of Nurses was established in 1898 by the Lady Ishbel Aberdeen, which signified a professional standard of education for student nurses, which not only recognized the need for altruism and compassion, but also established a need for knowledge in nursing. This is some pretty important stuff.
In 1908, the Canadian National Association of Trained Nurses was formed by Mary Snively. This name changed to what we currently know as the Canadian Nurses Association in 1924.
What a terrible time it was for nurses in World War I in 1914. Approximately 2,000, yes, 2,000 nurses were sent to Europe. 52 were killed in hospital bombings. They were granted officer status and military rank known as nursing sisters.
1914 to 1918, nurses expanded into specialties.
But wait, let's go back quickly to 1914, when Jean Gunn organized the university degree program in nursing. In 1919, it was our very own province that first adopted the university degree program, making UBC the first. Some students were taken advantage of in the clinical setting because of their lack of classroom knowledge and no instruction. In 1922, nursing registration acts were placed in all provinces. In 1927, Jean E. Brown, president of the CNA, stated that the nurses should offer intelligent cooperation to the physicians rather than blind obedience. Physicians opposed the statement because they didn't want anyone without medical license to give advice and interventions. In 1927, a committee of health professionals nominated a UBC professor to continue the investigation under a study known as Survey of Nursing Education in Canada, or the WEIR Report. The paper was published in 1932, and it hoped that the investigation would lend to further support to Canadians' claim to professionalism. The WEIR Report confirmed that the nurses' education was secondary to hospital service. In the same year, the federal government established the Department of Health and the Promotion of Health. World War I and the influenza pandemic also had a huge effect on the way nurses practiced and led to new patterns of health care delivery.
The Great Depression in the 1930s had a dramatic effect on health care. People could no longer afford to pay their medical bills, and this brought unemployment and poor working conditions for nurses. Also at this time, there were approximately 330 nursing schools spread across Canada. Bazinga!
Public health movement turned its attention to the needs of Aboriginal communities and settlers in Canada. 1939 to 1945 was a big time for Canadian nurses. Remember when Canada sent 2,000 nurses overseas in World War I? Well, that number tripled in World War II to 6,000 nurses. Yes, it was nice that we sent so many nurses overseas, but it also created a nursing shortage in Canada, so trained volunteers were needed to replace the nurses' positions.
The BC Nursing Association stood for the prevention of disease and for public health education. It was unionized in 1945.
Get this! It was during this time that the typical image of a nurse changed from white woman to encouraging visible minorities and men to enter the nursing profession. There was an increased awareness of gender, balance, cultural, ethnic, and religious diversity. Our favorite book, Potter and Perry, says that approximately 10% of nurses were men.
Up until the 1970s, the nursing cap was a symbol of professionalism which all nurses were recognized by.
The World Health Organization decided upon a definition of health in 1984 that is still used today. It focuses on health being an issue of society, and well-being is determined by many contributing factors.
Can you believe it? It wasn't until the year 2000 when all nurses were required to be qualified at a baccalaureate level in nursing. We made it! It's the 21st century.
From 2013 to today, approximately 90% of us ladies dominate the nursing field, with the minority being First Nations and Black Canadians. There's a nursing shortage, but don't worry, it'll be good for all of us nurses in 4 years. There has been and still is extremely long wait times for surgeries. In keeping with the times and to improve the speed of care, there's been an increase in the use of electronics in healthcare facilities. Nursing focuses on person-centered care and the nursing process, assessment, planning, implementation, and evaluation.
Currently, nurses are an essential part of the healthcare network and play an important role in patients' primary health assessment. A nurse's medical knowledge is now respected and even sought after by physicians, which wasn't the case in the past.
And that's a wrap!